most dangerous places to visit. Hey everyone, it's Alexa, and welcome back to Talltanic. Danger can mean anything, from crime rate and unpredictable weather to steep ground and more. What makes these places the most dangerous to visit in the world? Keep watching to find out. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and hit the bell icon so that you never miss any of our videos. Praia de Boa Viagem. Perfect weather, a picturesque coastline, and clean blue water. Sounds like a fabulous tropical vacation. What could be wrong with that? Not much, unless you hate sharks. This place in Brazil is a hotspot for both tourists and shark attacks. Since 1992, there have been over 56 shark attacks at the beach, and one-third of them ended in fatalities. The abundance of bull and tiger sharks that swim in the shallow waters off the coast of the beach account for why so many attacks happen. Unlike sharks found in deeper waters, these sharks lurk around in waters as shallow as 3 or 4 feet. The Colorado River System. Colorado is an outdoor lover's paradise where you can ski the Rockies in the winter and raft the Colorado River in the summer. But recently, the melting snowpack from the mountain ranges has created adverse and dangerous whitewater conditions. Rafting can be fun for the whole family, but not when someone goes overboard. In 2007, rafters at the Colorado River System reported close to 200 serious injuries and 12 fatalities. During just 7 months in 2014, authorities recorded 15 fatalities. Even though experience plays a part in navigating the Class 5 rapids, faster than normal currents and alcohol use also factor in. Cape Town, South Africa. Famous for its cityscape placed alongside Table Mountain, Cape Town ranks as a favorite city to visit among travelers. According to the Safe Around website, Cape Town, South Africa comes up as the 110th most dangerous city out of 162. What makes this port city so dangerous? Violent crime plagues parts of the country, and Cape Town is no exception. However, if you insist or need to go on vacation there, travel experts advise you do so under the instruction of a guide. Risk of crime depends on the districts and neighborhoods you enter. Erta-Ale Volcano. Any tourists who decide to visit an active volcano run the risk of danger. The inhospitable terrain surrounding the Erta-Ale volcano in Ethiopia makes visiting difficult for anyone wanting to experience the environment for themselves. Traveling through the region is also not advised, as it often experiences political and cultural turmoil between the peoples who reside there. The natural curiosity and sense of adventure in humans pushes many to see this volcano and its lake of lava in real life. If you must traverse here, make sure you come prepared for an 8.5-mile hike on uneven lava stones in the heat of the Ethiopian landscape. Oh, and the thick volcanic fumes. Be prepared for those, too. The beaches of Acapulco. Acapulco is a huge tourist attraction for Americans because of its easy access, luxurious resorts, fantastic weather, and beautiful beaches. Unfortunately, the crime rate of the nearby city is 30 times higher than in America. In 2013, 200 murders were committed in both January and February alone. The U.S. Department of State has issued warnings for anyone traveling to Acapulco. They recommend that tourists stay in the designated tourist areas. And if it is necessary to venture out, make sure you have enough gas to get you through the rougher parts of town. If possible, travel by plane and not by car. The State Department also places a curfew on its diplomats, forbidding them from venturing out after dark. Egypt. Egypt brings in a huge tourist crowd, not only for its archaeological attractions, but also for the beaches along the Nile River and the Red Sea. At the same time, Egypt experienced a lot of political and economic issues in the past couple of years. You can still go there and have a safe, fun time, so long as you avoid the no-go areas. The UK's Foreign and Commonwealth Office says it's safe to travel to places like Cairo, stay at Red Sea resorts, and enjoy Nile River activities. If anything, the FCO advises against going to North Sinai because of its high-level criminal activity. Cliffs of Moher. The Cliffs of Moher is one of the most magnificent and breathtaking views in all of Ireland, if not the world. The cliffs end at the edge of the Atlantic Ocean, creating a striking panorama. Visitors should pay heed to the warning signs, which caution hikers to stay far from the edge of the cliffs. High winds, unpredictable rain, and loose soil make for dangerous conditions. In 2006, one woman was swept off the cliffside by strong winds, and in 2010, a considerable chunk of the cliff fell into the ocean. Valley of Death, No, not Death Valley. The Valley of Death is in Russia, not the Californian desert. This dangerous valley measures only 1.2 miles long and 328 to 1,640 feet wide and sits at the bottom of a volcano. People began calling it the Valley of Death after it was discovered that animals frequently die when passing through here or even when flying overhead. Researchers say this happens due to the mix of poisonous gases, such as carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, carbon sulfur, and more. Visitors nearby often report feeling ill. El Caminito del Rey, Spain. The Caminito del Rey is a human-made path that's only 3 feet wide, yet it runs along a cliff face over 300 feet from the ground. The former tourist attraction closed in 2000 after 5 tourists fell to their deaths. Still, that fact hasn't stopped adventure seekers from attempting to climb it. The current pathway is even more dangerous than the original, as it has fallen into disrepair since it closed. In some parts, the wooden path is non-existent, save for the rusted metal rails that used to hold it up. That little snag in the road forces visitors to climb along the side of the mountain to where the path begins again. Despite the dangers, it remains a popular destination, so much so that money is being raised to pay for the extensive repairs necessary to reopen it to the public. Yosemite National Park's Half Dome. Some of the more popular activities at Yosemite National Park are camping, hiking, and climbing Half Dome. The Half Dome is a mountain that rises over 5,000 feet from its base. Walking up Half Dome takes an entire day. By the time the hiker's near the summit, an additional 400-foot vertical climb to the top waits ahead of them. Exhaustion and slippery conditions have led to over 60 deaths on Half Dome. The conditions turn so deadly that the bottom part of the cliff is known as the Death Slabs. Some die on impact, others get swept away in vernal falls. If that's not enough, be on the lookout for lightning, because that takes out a few people too. Hawaii's Volcano Tours. Hawaii is known for its volcanic activity. Naturally, tourists want to get a closer look at its world-famous volcanoes, but beware, because that sightseeing trip can turn deadly. Many helicopter and bicycle companies will get you to the top for around $100. From 1992 to 2002, the Hawaii Volcanoes National Park reported 45 major injuries and 40 deaths. Some die from losing control of their bikes, and some from the lava haze, which looks like a harmless cloud of water vapor, but in actuality contains a toxic mix of hydrochloric acid, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen sulfide. These gases can cause asphyxiation, asthma, and heart conditions. New Smyrna Beach. You'll find lots of swimmers, surfers, and sharks at Florida's famed New Smyrna Beach. The beach is often called one of the most dangerous beaches in the world. Since 1882, records show New Smyrna Beach to be the location of nearly 300 shark attacks. The Guinness Book of World Records named it the shark capital of the world. You'd think people would like avoid this place altogether, but this beach counts as a notable surfing spot as well. Swim at your own risk. Anik Gardens. Who doesn't enjoy a pleasant stroll through a well-manicured, proper English garden? You might want to think twice if you visit Anik Castle in Northumberland, England. After inheriting the castle, the Duchess of Northumberland decided to revamp the gardens. She thought ordinary flowers were uninteresting, so she planted poisonous ones instead. Thus, the Poison Garden was born. The path allows visitors to stand far away enough from the plants that they can't smell or touch them, but some people do faint from the toxic fumes the plants release into the air. In addition to the poisonous plants, the Duchess also included coca and cannabis plants to demonstrate how they can be deadly too. Mont Blanc. When you think of the French Alps, you probably don't associate them with the highest fatality rate of all the mountains in Europe. Mont Blanc is the tallest mountain in Europe, measuring 15,780 feet tall, making it very dangerous already by sheer height. 100 hikers per year die on the mountain. Amateur climbers should not try to climb Mont Blanc, yet a lot of beginners make up the 20,000 people that visit the summit each year. Death Road, Bolivia. Yungas Road is just about the most dangerous bike ride in the world. That's why it earned the nickname Death Road. Almost 300 bikers are killed annually trying to make it to the end of this narrow, steep road. The road is so dangerous that people from the adjacent town say a prayer before they use it. The drop from the side is 164 feet, and those not daunted by their possible demise speed across the path going around 40 miles an hour. So many people have lost their lives traveling this death road that graves and shrines now line the route. Not exactly the best sign when you're packing up to take a spin. Skellig Michael. For those unfamiliar with Skellig Michael, you can catch a glimpse of it in the latest Star Wars movie. Monks settled on this very remote island off the coast of Ireland between 600 and 800 AD. The monks specifically chose this location because it was hard to find and navigate. Visitors to Skellig Michael must endure an hour-long boat ride through rough seas. Once they arrive there, there is no guarantee that they will be able to dock due to the high waves and choppy water. Now, if they do make it ashore, they will not find the typical tourist amenities such as food or water, bathrooms, shelter, or a visitor center. Navigating the island is dangerous as well because to reach the site, you have to climb 600 ancient stone steps that wind up the side of a mountain without any handrails. Two deaths have been reported so far. But what is number one? Before we tell you, let's ask you something. Where's the most dangerous place you've ever visited? Would you say you're a daredevil, and would you visit any of these places? Or is this a list you would avoid? Let us know in the comments below. 1. Black Cat Trail. International hikers flock to New Guinea to try and defeat the treacherous path known as the Black Cat Trail. The trail used to be a World War II path. As a result of its history, it covers a variety of terrain that has become quite dangerous. Among the obstacles along the way, hikers will encounter cliffs, fallen trees, swamps, hazardous ledges, and rocks covered with moss. Due to its presence in the war, scattered around can often be found live bombs, boots, ammunition, and plane wrecks. There are also Japanese tunnels. The trail stretches 38 miles long, requiring a 4 or 5 day commitment. Despite the immense length and potential threat to a hiker's life, some people have managed to complete it in just 2 days.